Well, there's a dairy farm in southern New England that caught our attention recently, not because of the cows, but the shoes.
Not the shoes the cows are wearing, just to clarify here. Correspondent Michelle Miller went out to track down a little bit more on a rather surprising story of some very fashionable men behind milk.
On a snowy Connecticut hillside, thawing out from an autumn nor'easter, sits a beautiful dairy farm run by two men you'd least expect. George Malcolmus and Tony Yergaitis are dairy farmers every Thursday to Sunday. But any other day of the week, you can find them here.
Oh, I love this.
In New York City, running the high-end couture shoe company, Manolo Blahnik.
So it's the 20th of January.
George and Tony have been president and vice president of Manolo Blahnik for more than 30 years. Over the course of their tenure, they've hobnobbed with female celebrities, sold countless pairs of $800 stilettos, and built a brand every fashion-forward woman longs for.
Manolo Blahnik, Mary Jane's. I thought these were an urban shoe myth.
But their love of high heels is rivaled only by their love of heifers. And both are treated with the same passion. Just like their shoes, every cow has a name. And just like their customers, every cow is treated like a lady.
When a woman walks into a party in a pair of Manolo Blahnik shoes and everyone says, well, how fabulous you look, it's the same way that we feel when somebody applauds one of these cattle.
Mother of the brown Swiss.
In 1998, the partners in business and in life bought a defunct dairy farm across the street from their home in Litchfield, Connecticut. Their goal? Save it from developers and restore it to a fully functioning farm.
Farms have just disappeared all across the country. And so part of the love that we have is the preservation of land and the preservation of farmland in particular.
Today, Arethusa Farm has more than 400 cattle and employs more than 25 full-time employees who do everything from milking to bottling to scooping. It's a small business that's had a big impact on the local economy.
George and Tony have led by example every step of the way. They've given back to this community much more than they've taken from this community, and that's not lost on the people of this area.
Last year, they chose to open their dairy in an abandoned fire station on the main street of sleepy Bantam, Connecticut, far away from New York City's Fifth Avenue.
You run a major shoe company. I mean, couldn't you have done something about the design of these things? You like that?
In fashion. I love it. Don't you like the color?
Blue.
It is the color.
But don't let the great taste in Italian cashmere fool you. George and Tony are true dairy farmers every step of the way.
They're not here all the time. When they're here, they're working.
I come alive on the farm. I just love it here.
Admittedly, neither claim to do the real dirty work.
And it gets better with age. So.
Tony fancies himself the cheese man.
And this is a Gouda?
We hold it for it.
While George takes pride in his perfect waffle cones.
I have a tendency to make the biggest waffle cones. So the customer really gets their money's worth when they get a George Malcolmus waffle cone.
And their employees couldn't be happier.
I'm very proud to say that I work for Arethusa Farm Dairy. And anyone who works here, we're a family.
In addition to providing lifetime careers to local townspeople, George and Tony are also providing for the next generation. A recent tent sale of their gorgeous shoes raised $100,000 for scholarships that will send a child of a local farmer to agriculture school.
We have been very blessed in our lives with our partnership and with our business, and now with this farm. I mean, I think it's all about giving back.
It sure is.
So whether farmer or fashionista, it's clear George and Tony have a certain flair for success.
I'm so rich.
And impeccable taste. Michelle Miller, CBS News, Litchfield, Connecticut.